Ranjana, Dr. Ranjit Krishna, seated before me some of the most distinguished members of the fraternity, Dr. Ashok Das, Dr. Murugathan, Dr. Sheshan, Dr. Munshi, Dr. Sunil, Dr. Rakesh, and almost all of you that are familiar with me, and we've known each other for almost 3 to 4 decades now. Many of our standing colleagues there sitting in a single row. At the outset, I have to profusely thank Dr. Mohan. Honestly speaking, I don't deserve this, but he's been very kind. He's been very kind for whatever reasons, because I think there's still not much to do. But nevertheless, it's very overwhelming, and the manner he read out the citation, it was, I must confess, also a little embarrassing, being, you know, bracketed with Dr. B.C. Roy, which is of course beyond the comprehension or imagination of any one of us. But that is of course very encouraging. Thank you very much, Dr. Mohan. And having said that, I have to compliment you, and I have to compliment you for more than one reasons. I have to compliment Dr. Mohan for having raised the standards of scientific research, particularly that in diabetes, to the global levels. I have to compliment you for having earned for India a place of prestige in the world of research and development. And I also to compliment you for having brought Chennai and also India as a frontline center of diabetes research in the world. And last but not the least, I have to compliment you for having very illustriously carried forward the legacy of Professor M. Vishwanathan, who in his lifetime itself got to be known as the father of diabetology in India, which is something very unusual. And I'm glad all of us are around to see the legacy being very beautifully passed on to Dr. Ranjana. And this also gives me an added pleasure that it virtually sounds like a Stanley Old Boys Club. Because Professor Vishwanathan was our teacher there, Mohan was my senior, Vijay was my junior. And I am glad that all of us have virtually done hand-holding for each other, like the late Vishwanathan Professor did. Coming to the subject that Professor Mohan was talking about, of course all of us know and highly need to tell each other that we are now also virtually having a diabetes epidemic in this country, with more than 101 million and even more the number of pre-diabetics, virtually 136 million or so. I think there too, Mohan deserves to be complimented for having churned out easy formula, both for the patients as well as for the doctors. For the doctors, this easy handbook, which I said can be kept on the table of every practicing clinician. And for the patient, notes just now, where he said that many people don't comply with this ABC. If they do, they might live longer by 60, 50 years. And that reminded me that it is in fact an authentication of what Dr. B.C. Roy's generation had learned by observation. My first guide when I was a junior resident happened to be Dr. one of the oldies of the same generation, Dr. Pathania. He was an MBBS student in Edward Medical College, Lahore. And then of course when the partition happened, so he came over here. Professor Ahuja came to Madras and he went to Amritsar. So they were contemporaries. So he used to tell us, because he was a medico when you just had insulin, nothing more than that, maybe in 40s. So he said his teachers used to tell him that incidentally, sometimes it's a blessing to get diabetes, because diabetes live longer than the non-diabetics. Maybe that was their general observation, clinical based. But now we have the authentication reason for that, because maybe they become more disciplined and they take care of their parameters. Maybe they were doing that in a different way about 70 years ago, when you didn't have all these diagnostic and monitoring facilities. But I'm glad that now this has been authenticated and we have reason evidence based to tell our patients. The other aspect which I think Dr. Mohan's institution needs to be complimented is that they have also concentrated on the rural sector, the rural patients, which is often not happening through the corporate hospitals. And more so when, rightly, one of his notes observes that the rural area is also getting equally impacted. In fact, way back somewhere in 2005 or 2006, there was a paper of mine published in JAPI, the title of which was Breakdown in Rural and Urban Divide. Because all those factors which possibly prevented a rural population from becoming as vulnerable, as susceptible as the urban population were actually vanishing away, and the diabetes is too serious a matter to be left to a diabetologist or an endocrinologist alone. It has a huge cultural, social bearings. So all these things vanish as a whole, and that also involves the disease factor. So in a way, when a successful corporate setup also starts taking care of the rural, it not only serves the patient of that area, but it also sets a beautiful example for others to serve. In fact, about 15 years back, I was talking to Trehan, because they have formed an association of corporate hospitals. I said, you better start looking after the rural, otherwise rural will come and protest again outside your hospital.